been written by Moses, while some say it is a psalm of David. Whoever is the author, this psalm is the song of assurance of God's protection. The psalm begins with an acknowledgement of the protection, comfort, and care of God enjoyed by his people. The psalmist calls God Most High, All Powerful, Almighty, and the place of shelter and refuge and fortress. So the psalmist calls God as a shelter and refuge and fortress. In the following verses, that is verse 3 and 4, the psalmist speaks how God brings his protection and comfort to his people. Verse 4 says, he will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and a buckler. Many a times we must have seen pictures of birds protecting their young ones. How comfortably and how protected they appear under the wings of the mother bird. Here, God also offers to all of us such protection, where he promises to protect us under his wings from everything that can cause harm to us, including deadly pestilences. In this section, we can notice how God speaks to us in a one-to-one fashion. Here he says, you will be protected, you will find the shelter, you will be under his wings. And he says that he is going to be a shield and a buckler. Here, the psalmist uses two modes of protection. One is the shield and the other one is the buckler. A shield, you all know, is an instrument which is used during wars to protect from the attacks of the enemy. And a buckler is an overall protection that is right around the warrior. So here, God protects us from any attack from our enemies, and he forms a buckler, an all-round protection around us. In the next two verses, that is verse 5 and 6, it speaks about the result of God's protection and care. Here, the psalmist speaks about the dangers that can come from all, in all kinds of ways and in multiple ways and at multiple times. It says it could come by night or by day, in darkness or at noonday. It could come as terror or by arrow or as a pestilence right now, which we all are facing, or as a destruction. Now, whenever or however it comes, God is able to defend and protect his people. Further, in verse 7 and 8, it gives assurance to the believer that 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, it will not come near you. The psalmist describes how God's protection could conquer any odds and possibilities, and God's protection and care could be so specifically focused that it can preserve 1 in 10,000 also. So, brethren, as we hear about so much of destruction, so much of death and pain all around us, we can be assured in the faithfulness of God that he is going to be our protector. Further, in verse 11, he says, for he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. So there is an army of angels which are right around us. Even as we speak, there is a spiritual realm which we cannot see or comprehend, in which God has assigned his angels to be our protection. So brethren, as we are facing this pestilence, this fear that is gripping all of us all around the world, We need to be assured that we have an all-powerful, almighty God who is our protection, who is committed to protect his people, those who call upon his name. As David was praying, as we call upon his name, we can be rest assured that God is our protection and he is there to comfort and care for us. On the whole, this psalm speaks to us about the blessing of his presence, his protection, his preservation and prosperity of long life. Even though we face the scares of losing our lives, we can be assured that God in his faithfulness will carry out his will in our lives. Am I audible?
Yeah, you're audible. I don't know from where the noise is coming. Yeah, it's fine now.
Yeah. So, brethren, if you are on the edge, concerned, or downright in panic over the corona pandemic, certainly all of us are scared. All of us are worried. Some of us are in panic. But one thing, let us not allow this fear or panic to grip us, because Psalm 91 reminds us that God is our protector, he is our shelter, he is our shield, and God is in control of everything. Let us not forget that this God whom we worship, the Almighty, the All-Powerful God, is the creator of the universe. He holds the whole world and the universe in his hand. So let us not be scared, let us not be worried, but trust in the faithfulness of God, because he cares and he loves us. I think and I hope that these few words have encouraged not only you but all of us, and I believe that these verses will uplift us and help us to trust in this loving God we serve. Thank you.